Welcome to the Coupler.io Academy, where industry experts share tips and tricks on working with data. In this video, we will explain how to use IMPORTRANGE with QUERY in Google Sheets. Each of these functions will be able to simplify your analysis when used individually. However, it's only by combining the QUERY function with IMPORTRANGE that you'll be able to collect data from different spreadsheets and manipulate it to your liking, all within the same formula. Sounds amazing, doesn't it? Let's jump to Google Sheets for a quick recap, and then I'll show you various examples of using a QUERY IMPORTRANGE formula. In this video, I'll work with the data about invoices that my company has issued over the years. Each fiscal year has a separate spreadsheet, and I'll show you how to combine and process that data with the help of IMPORTRANGE and QUERY. If you'd like to follow along, you'll find the link to this spreadsheet in the top right corner of the screen, as well as in the video description below. To combine data across different sheets or spreadsheets, I will use IMPORTRANGE. As a reminder, it has two parameters: spreadsheet URL, or the ID you can extract from that URL, and the data range you want to fetch. If it's the first sheet from the spreadsheet, it's enough to just provide a range. In any other case, you must also state the sheet name. Here's an example of IMPORTRANGE in Google Sheets. Into the 2023 file, I'm fetching all the invoices from 2022 and selecting the entire table as a data range. With Google Sheets QUERY, on the other hand, you can filter, sort, group, pivot, and do many other things to your data. The syntax for QUERY is as follows. Data range in your spreadsheet, which features a sheet name, an exclamation mark, and the desired range, the query itself wrapped in quotes, and the optional headers parameter. If skipped or set to -1, Google Sheets will guess where the header is, and from my experience, it does this really well. Here's an example of QUERY in my spreadsheet. From the previously imported data, I'm selecting columns A, B, and E, fetching only the invoices that have been paid and ordering by the invoice value in descending order. If you're interested in delving deeper into QUERY, we have a dedicated video about it. Check out the link in the corner of your screen. Needless to say, QUERY is a very powerful function, but it can only work with the data inside the same spreadsheet. That's why combining it with IMPORTRANGE is so useful. So, here's how to do it. In an empty cell in your spreadsheet, type QUERY, open parenthesis, and then add IMPORTRANGE. Its first parameter is the URL of the spreadsheet or a spreadsheet ID derived from that URL. The latter is shorter, and I personally prefer it, so I'll fetch it from my 2022 spreadsheet. Next, I specified the range to fetch, which will be the entire sheet. Let's close the parenthesis, and I'll now type in the query to apply to this data. Because I'm using query with another function, I can no longer refer to columns with letters. Instead, I have to use col1, col2, and so on. So, I'll select columns 1, 3, and 5, which will be an invoice ID, account name, and the amount. Column 4 indicates whether an invoice was paid or not. I'll fetch just the unpaid invoices. What's more, I'll limit the import to just the invoices from the first quarter of 2022. A word of explanation here. Google Sheets stores dates as serial numbers, while QUERY requires them to be string laterals. To use a date in the WHERE statement, you must add a date word before an actual date. If it's the first time you're fetching data from that spreadsheet, you'll need to allow access to it. Don't worry, on the next occasion, data will be fetched automatically without any interruptions. And here's the list of unpaid invoices from the first quarter of 2022. Of course, I can now order it however I like. For example, by the highest amount, group by the account name, and do plenty of other things. But I'll leave that for another example. Let's now see how to combine data from another spreadsheet with what's already in the current spreadsheet and manipulate that data. I type in the query function with IMPORTRANGE nested inside. From the 2022 file, I grabbed the spreadsheet ID. As usual, I then specify the data range, then close the parenthesis. I want to combine the data I fetch from another file with what's in my invoices tab here. So I'll make a reference to that sheet indicating the same range. Because I'm fetching data from more than one location, I need to wrap the whole data range into curly brackets to indicate an array. It is important to note here that every element of an array that you add will need to have the same number of columns. The row numbers, however, can differ. As for the query itself, I'll just fetch all unpaid invoices, ordering them by the invoice value, starting from the most expensive ones. And here's the result. As you can see, I have invoices from 2023 as well as 2022 sorted together by amount. Of course, you're not limited to fetching data from just one external spreadsheet. You can combine numerous spreadsheets and sheets, and Google Sheets will merge them together in your desired way. Let's have a look at another example. My invoices date back to 2021, and there's yet another spreadsheet. I'll grab its ID right away and jump back to my other spreadsheet. Here, instead of the reference to the Invoices tab, I'll put another import range, add the spreadsheet ID, and the same data range as everywhere else. Let's keep the query as it was and hit Enter. Oops, I got an error about missing values for one or more rows. At first, it may seem hard to guess what this is exactly about, so I'll help you out. Remember how Google Sheets was requesting access to a spreadsheet in one of the previous examples? If you run a single import range, Google Sheets will pull up a window asking if you allow access to a file you haven't shared before. However, if you run multiple import ranges at a time and Sheets don't have access to even one file, you'll get a rather cryptic error instead. Luckily, it's easy to fix this. Copy the import range function from the file Google Sheets may not have access to. In another sheet, type in the equal sign and the function you just copied. Then grant the required access. At this point, you can delete the formula, and if you have more import ranges with this problem, repeat this step for each of them. I previously granted access to the first spreadsheet, so I already jumped back, and voila, the data from both spreadsheets is now imported. You can see invoices for 2022 as well as 2021 here. In the formula, I used the semicolon to separate the two import ranges. This tells Google that I want to merge the data vertically, and I guess it will work for most use cases. However, if you prefer a horizontal merge, you can use a comma instead. It will put both imports next to each other, making it perhaps easier to compare both datasets. However, when merging horizontally, you can't apply ordering by two columns at a time. Here, for example, it could make sense to order by the amount column in both files to see the most valuable invoices for each year. To achieve that, you'll need to use other Google Sheet functions, such as HStack. Now, let's have a look at a more advanced example. I'll scan through all my spreadsheets with invoices, looking for a specific account name. I'll also build a pivot table with some aggregate and scalar functions. Not to repeat myself, I prepared a basic query that fetches invoices from 2021, 2022, as well as 2023, so the current spreadsheet. All it does is return all data from all three files. Everything seems fine, but if you scroll down, you would see that only one data set was fetched, the one for 2021. Is that so? What really happened is that Google Sheets fetched each dataset along with hundreds of empty rows and used them to separate one import from another. This makes my data rather hard to process. So before I get to the example, I'll need to sort this out. There are different ways to go about empty rows in Google Sheets query. You could, for example, add a where statement telling query to only fetch rows where a certain column is not empty, such as the first column in my example. Let's extend the formula cell as my function no longer fits in one line. And check the results. Yes, now the data sets have merged correctly. Another thing you could do is add any kind of ordering. For example, sorting by the amount column. It would push all the empty rows down outside our field of interest. I'll use it in my example, so let's get to it. In my dataset, I have several different entities for the HP company. Here's Portugal, then Brazil, Brazil again, and there's also South Africa somewhere down the table. Rather than filter for each entity separately, I'll fetch all the results for all HP companies at once and then break that down into each entity separately. I'll update the where statement here. I'll use the starts with operator to collect all invoices that start with the word HP. I'll continue my focus on the unpaid invoices only. And I'll order by the column E descending. Okay, this got me all unpaid invoices from HP, sorted by the highest value. Let's take this analysis further and build a pivot table. I'll cut the order by and instead add the group by clause, grouping by the account name. And let's also pivot using the year bracket scalar function to extract the year an invoice was issued. I can no longer select all columns as each column needs to be either aggregated or grouped by. So let's select the column with account names and the sum of invoice amount. Ha! Awesome! This now provides me with the summary of unpaid invoices for each of the HP entities, broken down into the year of issue. With such a comprehensive overview, I can now go chase them to finally pay their bills. Jokes aside, I did want to tell you about one more useful thing. If you import data a lot between different sheets or business apps, you may find it easier and much faster to employ dedicated apps for data automation. They tend to cover plenty of import range and query functionalities and add a lot more on top of that. One such app is Coupler.io, which basically collects data from dozens of apps, transforms it for you, and brings it to your spreadsheet or other tool of choice. All of it in a no-code environment with a 5-minute setup. In my case, I could fetch data at once from all my invoice spreadsheets. Then I could preview my data and apply filters like those I had in my earlier examples. I can sort and even create new columns with custom formulas. For example, I may want to calculate how many days it's been since an invoice was issued. Once I'm happy with the result, I can run an import or set up a schedule too. For example, fetch the fresh data daily or hourly. And here's the imported data in my spreadsheet. That's it. Now you know how to combine the query function with import range in Google Sheets. But if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. If you've enjoyed this video, then please give us a like, share this video with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.